So we were just looking at the partnership with Accelera and CoAsia to build our order flow system. That's really revolutionizing warehouse and supply hubs. But hardware is just only one piece of the puzzle. Ultimately, it's also going to boil down to how the software application is being built. And we did that together with Hipert and we're with Vittoria. Yeah. So thank you very much for joining us to briefly talk about the software piece of the puzzle. So can you perhaps explain a bit on how you build the software layer of this?
Okay, so first of all, we understood that we have a view of the drawer from the top. So we decided to focus on the hand of the agent, of the operator. And so we decided to search for a model, a neural network, that could recognize the hand in the image. So we did some scouting of the possible model, and we chose the best one for this situation. And so what we receive in input is an image, and what we get in output is the same image with a rectangle telling us where the hand is in that image. And then once we know where the hand is in the image, we can also know where the cells of the drawer are, because we know in advance the dimensions of this drawer and the cells. And thanks to that, we can understand if the hand is interacting with the cell or is outside the drawer. So once we know that, we can understand when the action starts and when the action ends, because it exits the drawer. And then, when it's finished, we can compare the image of the cell before and after the action, and we can understand if a change has been made. So if there was a grab or release of some objects. So in this way, we can monitor the agent acting on the drawer, basically.
That's really cool. And ultimately, what it's going to help, right, it's going to reduce the human error, right? Because it's recognizing if you, for example, put something here in a box, but you put it in the wrong box, then they're like, hey, well, listen up, that's wrong, yeah. Right? I mean, that's what's happening here, right?
Yeah, exactly. When, of course, when we know in advance the list of actions that the operator has to do, and we can warn him when he's doing something wrong because maybe he's tired or he's, I don't know, for whatever reason he do something wrong, we can correct him thanks to this system, basically.
Great. And when building this application together with System Electronics, etc., so were there any challenges that you had in the process? Or?
Well, I would say that when the model we found should be fine-tuned for the specific context, because now is more general purpose for hands. While now we would like to more fine-tune it for this specific context of the warehouse and the drawer and this kind of stuff. And maybe I would say also the comparing of before and after is difficult to filter out the noise of just some light changing or shades that are not a real change of the drawer, but just environment noise. So this, I would say, are the most challenging things.
Yeah. And what sort of applications you could foresee that this will this can be used in if you look in the real world?
Well, I think this could be applied in many different contexts where first you have to monitor someone, like could be a warehouse, could be an assembly line or whatever. But we can also transfer this to not the hand but some other part of the body. So it could be the face, the feet or whatever. So it could be for monitoring or, yeah, I think many kind of applications. Yeah.
So just by building this application pipeline and everything, you just enable a whole lot of new applications that is going to use AI just for the better, just for the good.
Yeah, exactly.
Good. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dewey. It was a pleasure.
Likewise.
Bye-bye.